Hello everyone and welcome to another tutorial in EVE Online. Today I wanna talk about how you can multibox abysses in frigates or destroyers. The first thing you have to do before you can enter the abyssal is to form a fleet with your alts. This is quite simple. Just click Form Fleet With, accept with all the alts, and then you have to set up your watch list. You do this by going to Fleet and enter to watch list. You do that on every alt with all your other characters. This allows you to see on every client who takes damage, who needs reps and so on. Also you can easily lock your fleet members by just control and clicking those names. A setting that is very important and useful in the Abyss is the sequence tagging. I use the sequence tagging from 1 to 9. You have to set the shortcut first. Is by default not set. We're gonna look at this later. Another important tool is the regroup command from the fleet window. If you activate this, all your other characters will orbit the fleet commander at around 300 to 500 meters. This is very useful so that you can keep your fleet together and never have to click approach or keep at range manually on each character. Now we're gonna look at what you do when you enter the Abyss. For the purpose of this tutorial, I will just do a T1, as it is not meant to be a tutorial on how to use the setup that I'm using. It is just to show how to multibox any frigate abyssal. So let's go into the Abyss. When you enter it, all your characters will spawn at some point and will not be moving, and you have a 1 minute invulnerability timer. During this timer you activate all your modules that you need and tag the NPCs. I do it with the sequence tagging with the key that I have set before. You just have to press the key, click the red, and then it gets tagged. Then you hit approach on something, click the regroup, and lock all your fleet members that you have to lock up. Now I activate one remote rep on each of the characters and keep that third one as a backup. And I also activate the remote rep on the decon in this particular setup. Then all you have to do is to look up the NPCs, shoot them, take the loot, and then after you kill the NPC, just have to move on to the next room and do the same over again. Before you activate the gate with any of your characters, make sure that you hit approach on all of your characters if you use the regroup command before. Because if the leader takes the gate, all the other characters will just move away in a straight line, and if there's a speed cloud at the gate, then it can take some time to activate the gate with that alt, and if you need the remote reps in the next room, that can be very dangerous if you don't have it. So make sure you hit approach on the gate with all characters before you take it. When you enter either the second or third room, then your characters will start moving to the gate straight away, and you only have 15 second invulnerability timer to tag the NPCs, move your leader to take aggro and regroup. It is so that the first ship that moves takes aggro. Then you activate remote traps if you have, take loot and kill the rats. And then you move to the next room. Also keep in mind that if your leader is faster than your alts, then they will start dropping back over time. So be mindful of that. Because depending on what room it is, this can become quite dangerous if the NPCs switch to one of your fleet members. Like in this case, the battleship starts shooting the retribution, and if it was like 20k away, then it could actually take a wrecking shot from the battleship. So always pay attention to where your fleet members are, especially if there are blue clouds, speed clouds or tracking towers. So now we just kill those NPCs, then we take the gate and go to the last room. Something that is also important is to manage your remote reps. Do not always just turn on all three, just turn on two, because this can affect who takes aggro. If you only want two of the reps on the decon, then it is less likely that the rats will switch to your decon. Most of the time they will shoot the retribution or the Nurgle and rarely the decon. Also, if you have reactive armor hardeners fixed, make sure that you reset those before you go into the next room. Also, turn on your remote traps to get some cap back. Hit approach on the gates with all your characters, and then you activate them. Now we're in the last room. Again, you have 15 seconds to tag the NPCs. Make a move with the ship that should take aggro first and regroup. And start your reps like before. And kill all the NPCs. The exact process when you enter a new room also depends on what setup you end up running. Like in a setup with a logistic frigate, then you actually activate remote traps first. But if you use a setup with like three DPS ships like Triple Hawks or Triple Retribution, then you actually just move the tank, hit regroup, kill the rats and use the remote traps when needed. Also, the software that I'm using to manage all the clients is EVO Preview, but there are some other tools that you can use like ISBoxer and so on, but I would not recommend using those tools because they have options that are not allowed by the if on a EULA and terms of service, like input broadcasting, input multiplexing and modifying of the client. So use EVO Preview. I will put the link into the description of the video so that you can download it and use it. Also, whether you use EVO Preview or not also depends on your setup. If you have like three monitors or you manage all your clients on one screen, then you probably do not need it at all. But in my case, I have two monitors and three clients. So with this setup of the Nurgle, Retribution and Deacon, I put the Retribution on my second screen and the Nurgle and the Deacon on my first screen. so that I can switch between those with the Evo preview. As with the Deacon, I don't have to do too much stuff, so I can keep it in the background most of the time, so that I have always the DPS ships visible that I can do stuff. Also in the description there are links to my TikTok, Twitch and Discord server, as well as links to forum posts about returning the old Abyssal Arena. So make sure that you like and comment in those if you wanna see a second gate in the last room of a Cruiser Abyssal. I hope this was helpful to you. Thank you for watching and see you all next time.